I'm Claire Binns. I'm Joint Managing Director at Picturehouse Cinemas and one of the programmers of Sundance Film Festival. Sundance London has been at Picturehouse Central for 5 years. This is our fifth year. Originally, Sundance London was at another venue at the O2. When we were building Picturehouse Central, we thought we want some of that because Sundance London very much does a lot of the things that we like to feel we do at Picturehouse, supporting independent film, diversity, etc. So we said to Sundance, come to us, and they are, and it's been a very happy, productive relationship since then. We start out, we're really working on this all year round, so we have to set our dates, we have to make sure that we clear all the decks ready to cooperate, to work with all the teams at Sundance, the filmmaking teams, the people that make the films, to make sure they're all available, get them into town. We want to put interesting panels together, all the marketing, all the operational stuff. It's a huge, huge project for us, but worth every single bit of it. Just picking a couple of films, I would pick Animals, directed by Sophie Hyde, who made the very, very good 52 Tuesdays. It's written by a woman who, it's her first screenplay. She wrote the book, Animals. We have both the stars of the film, Holiday Grainger, here. And I think that, to me, the story, which is about a woman's friendship, two women reaching their 30s, perhaps thinking maybe we've parted too long. I think it really explores women's friendship, and yet it's all a female team. The producer, Sarah Brocklehurst, is here, who spent 5 years getting the film made. So I think for people that want to see a really entertaining, great film, your chance to see it. Sophie Hyde on panels talking about how it is to make films. All the filmmakers and the cast here. It's a great chance for people to really understand what an independent film is all about and how the end product is entertaining and funny and delightful. First and foremost, independent film is about getting the finance to make it. So, you know, if you have studio backing, obviously the money is there, but there's the restrictions that come with that because they're going to want something very particular. An independent film is people going out, raising the money, taking the risks. It's really, you can have your voice in an independent film, but it's much harder to get that film financed and across the line and into cinemas. And Picturehouse play a part in that, being a distributor as well. We've also got here playing The Last Tree by Shola Amoo, which is a small independent film. It's his first big feature film. We will not only be playing it, but as Picturehouse Entertainment, we'll be releasing it as well. So that's taking a new voice from the UK and bringing that voice into the world, which we're excited and proud to do. And Shola is here also talking on a panel about getting your short film and how you get from a short film to a feature film. So very interesting for budding filmmakers that want to understand the process of getting your film from a short to a feature. Women directors that have come up have tended to come up through independent films, and that's still the case. I think there's much more sympathy now with financing to give women a chance, but I still think we've got a long way to go. To think the idea that it's all wonderful now is just not the case. I think it's still, the financing is still very much in male hands, and I think there's lots of films and lots of examples of films that still people are saying, but that's niche, that's not, but women make up 50% of the audience, and I think therefore there's a lot of stories that can and will be told that will reflect far more what the people going to the cinema actually want to see. Well, a lot of filmmakers who go on to make the big blockbusters have to start out, learn their craft. Independence is about, one, learning your craft. It's about challenging the norm. It's about finding your voice. It's about taking subjects that may be difficult or challenging or exploring things. And I think that's what Sundance does so well. Not only does it show films, but it helps writers and directors create those films. So in my mind, being a part of this and keeping that diversity and that range of cinema alive on the big screen is so important for us and so important for audiences. I mean, these films are made for the big screen. The films that are going on platforms, it's great, but at the end of the day, you can get up, make a cup of tea. It's not the same experience. You can see a film in a packed cinema on a big screen, but maybe you can see it with 10 people on a wet afternoon. There is nothing like seeing it on a cinema screen. And frankly, as I said, cinema directors do not make their films to be seen on a TV where people not really concentrating on their phone, having a cup of tea, and also it sort of disappears into the ether. Whereas an opening on a cinema is exciting and thrilling and very different. And I think if you were to ask any filmmaker, they would say theatrical every time.